Hi guys, welcome to the 7th episode of our RX Swift series for beginners. In the previous episode, we played with RX Data Sources framework and split the foods into main courses and desserts. Pretty cool! We'll continue our journey to extend our app with a login screen. We'll see how validations are done in RX Swift and RX Coco, and we'll introduce more observable properties and operators. I went ahead and added a login view controller. Let's see it first into our main storyboard. Here, it is the root view controller of the navigation controller. So the app will start by displaying it first. It has a username and a password field that the user will need to provide in order to see the foods menu. So if the credentials are okay, the food list will be displayed. If they are wrong, an alert will be shown. Let's open the login view controller Swift file. I already added in here the validation and the navigation logic. The credentials are valid if the username is an email address and the password has at least 6 characters. Great! Let's bring this controller to life and see how to take the input entered by the user and send it to the login method. We'll start by defining a dispose bag. Then, pretty similar to how we did in the case of the search bar, we'll take the inputs from the username and the text and the password text fields using the RX extension. We're interested in the text observable property, either empty or not. Let's say observable 1. And the same observable 2. Now we need to combine the two of them, and we'll do that using the combine latest operator. Let's quickly take a look at the RX Marble diagrams to better understand what combine latest does for us. As we can see, it combines the latest events emitted by the two observable sequences. Take a look at the 3D pair. We don't have any 3C or 3B, as B and C were emitted before D, which was the latest event emitted by the second observable. So when the first observable emitted 3, it just paired with the latest element emitted by the second observable, which is D. Cool. Let's return to our login view controller and define a third observable for combine latest result. Now, when the user taps the login button, we'll use our observable combined and send the emitted results to the login method. To do that, we'll use the tap event from the RX extension. Then, we'll apply the with latest from operator has to eat our combined observable. Observable combined. I invite you to check this on your own using the RX Marble diagrams, and if you have any questions, just post them in the comments section below. Cool! And finally, we'll subscribe to this observable sequence and implement the onNext closure. Calling the login function with the default arguments we receive in the closure. $0 is the username and $1 is the password. This is a more concise way of writing code. We could have written username password in, as in our previous episodes, but for the sake of diversity, let's take now this approach. Here we need to specify the self, as the compiler suggests. And finally, let's take care of the memory management and use the disposeby method. Great! That's it! The compiler is happy, so let's go ahead and run our project to see how it looks like. Here's our login view. If we just hit the login button, we'll get an alert asking us to provide a valid username and password. Same if we enter something that's not valid. So, let's now just go ahead and enter valid credentials in order for us to see what happens. Fantastic! Here's our food list. Before wrapping up, let's see how to make this code even more concise. First, we'll get rid of the observable 1 and observable 2 and blend them directly into the combine latest sequence. There. Then, if we want to be even more concise, let's add the combine latest observable directly into the with latest from operator. Cool. Looks nice and clean and easy to read. And that concludes our episode. Let's quickly wrap up what we did so far. We use the RX text observable properties to take the input from the user, then we combine them with the aid of the combine latest operator into one observable sequence, and when we receive the tap event from the user, we just passed the latest event emitted by the combine observable sequence to the login method. Thank you very much for watching. And see you in the next episode. Cheers!